Hello, my dear children. I hope all of you are fine and safe. Children, today we are going to start with chapter number 30 of GK, and the name of the chapter is pollution. So what is pollution? Any activity which is carried out by humans and which pollutes the air, water or land is called pollution. Okay? कोई भी एक्टिविटी जो हमारे एयर वाटर और लैंड को गंदा करती हो दैट इज कॉल्ड पोल्यूशन. सो व्हाट यू हैव टू डू इन दिस चैप्टर इज यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई द पिक्चर्स एंड देन यू हैव टू राइट द करेक्ट आंसर फ्रॉम द गिवन क्लूज. ओके, वेरी सिंपल चैप्टर. सो फर्स्ट इज यू कैन सी इन द पिक्चर स्मोक इज रिलीज्ड बाय द व्हीकल. ओके, so what it causes? It causes air pollution. It pollutes the air. Okay, so the answer is air pollution. Secondly, you can see that the chemical is thrown into the water by the factories, by the industries. Okay, so it is polluting the water. So the answer will be water pollution. Okay, now third you see children, this lady is throwing the garbage in an open area. Okay, so because of this what happens? It pollutes the soil, it pollutes the land. So the answer is soil pollution. Okay, then let's move on to the fourth question. See, you can see this dhobi uncle is washing the clothes in lakes and ponds. Okay, so what happens when he washes the clothes in lakes and ponds? It pollutes the water. Okay, so the answer is water pollution. Okay, then fifth image, you see that lot of smoke is being released by the factories. Now this smoke is very dangerous for human beings as well. Okay, and it is polluting our air. So the answer is air pollution. Okay, now sixth, you can see loud music is being played and it is very harmful for our ears. So the answer is noise pollution. Okay, noise pollution. One more thing children, you see in trivia very important information is given that light pollution, it is also known as photo pollution or luminous pollution. Okay, and now Diwali is coming, you all know. So children, and you know Diwali is coming, and you also know that the pollution level is on a very high, right? The pollution level have increased a lot. So what we should do, we should say no to crackers, as burning crackers causes, what does it cause? It causes air and noise pollution. Okay, so I hope all of you will not burn crackers this time. See children, Diwali is just not about burning crackers. You all can do other things on Diwali, like you can spend time with your families, you can decorate your houses. Okay, so this is a promise I want from all of you that no one is going to burn crackers on Diwali. Okay, now let's move on to the next chapter, that is chapter number 31. Now this chapter is very easy, as you must have seen some of these seeds at your home also. And if you have not seen these seeds, what you can do, you can ask your mother to show it. Okay, it must be there in your kitchen, so you can see also. Okay, so let us see what is written here. Chapter number 13 is spices. Okay, following are some spices which add rich flavor and taste to our food. Okay, what you have to do in this picture, you have to identify the spices. Spices ko hum Hindi mein kya bolte hain? Masale. Okay, masale. ठीक है, मसाला या मसाले. सो यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई द स्पाइसेस गिवन बिलो एंड देन यू हैव टू राइट देयर नेम्स विद द हेल्प ऑफ क्लूज गिवन. okay? Now, first picture is the picture of turmeric. In Hindi, we call it haldi, okay? So, what do we call turmeric in Hindi? Haldi. So, first picture is of turmeric. Second picture, you can see, it is the picture of garlic, okay? In Hindi, we call it lahsun, okay? Then, third picture is of ginger, okay? Third picture is of ginger. In Hindi, we call it adrak, okay? Adrak. Then, fourth picture, you can see in your kitchen also, this one, this is called cumin, okay? This is called cumin. And in Hindi, we call it jeera, okay? Now, let's come to the fifth one. Fifth one, you can see this spices is put in kheer also, okay? And in biryani also, and this is called cardamom, okay? In Hindi, we call it ilaichi, okay? What do we call it? Ilaichi. Then, sixth, you can see it's in powdery form. So, this is called mango powder. And in Hindi, it is called amchur powder. Okay? Amchur powder. Seventh one, bachcho, you can see it is in red color and a very thin material. Okay? So, it is saffron. Okay? It is mostly grown in Kashmir. It is saffron. It adds a very, very nice and tasty flavor, okay, to the food. Now, eighth, you can see these are some leaves. What are they called? They are called mint, okay. In Hindi, we call it pudina, okay. Aapki mama shayad ghar mein pudine ki chutney bhi banati hogi. So, this is that picture, the picture of mint, okay. Then, ninth one, this black small balls. So, these are called black pepper. And in Hindi, we call it Kali Mirch. Okay. Then, tenth, you see, this is the picture of red chili. And in Hindi, we call it Lal Mirchi. Okay. Then, 11th one, you can see, children, this is the picture of cloves. Okay. Cloves. And in Hindi, what do we call it? We call it long. You know that this is a home remedy that when our teeth pains, when we have a toothache, if we keep long or cloves in between our teeth, then the toothache stops. Okay? Or it reduces. Even when you are having cough, then you can put some two cloves in your mouth and then your cough will stop. Okay? It will help you in recovering from that. So, this is a home remedy. You can ask your mother also. Now, 12th one. Let's come to the 12th one. 12th, you see, these are also very small balls. And this is the picture of mustard seeds. Mustard seeds. And in Hindi, we call it sarso ke dane. Okay? So, bachcho, I hope all the spices you have identified, okay, and you can also see it in the kitchen in real, okay. Please ask your mother to show all these spices in real, okay. So, please read what is written here. Spices come from the seeds, fruits or barks of plants, okay. Cardamom and pepper are seeds of plants, okay. From where do we get cardamom and pepper? These are the seeds of plants. Cloves are the flower buds, while ginger and turmeric are the roots. Okay, they are roots. Fine. Now, children, let's move on to the next chapter. So, next chapter is chapter number 32, and the name of the chapter is National Symbols. Now, this chapter, children, you have studied in SST also. In SST, it is chapter number 12, okay? And it is a very easy chapter, right? So, let us revise what you have studied in SST. So, first is find the correct word to complete these statements. First is, our flag has dash colors. Our flag has how many colors? 3 colors. So the answer is 3. Which all colors are there? Saffron, white and green. Okay. Then saffron color stands for sacrifice. The answer is sacrifice. Then white color, children, which is in the middle, it stands for peace. Okay. Then fourth one, green color. Green color, it stands for fertility or prosperity. Okay. And children, in the middle, there is a Ashoka Chakra also. Okay. And how many spokes it has got? It has got 24 spokes. Okay. It has got 24 spokes. And from where this Ashoka Chakra has been taken? It has been taken from the national emblem. Okay. It has been taken from the national emblem, which you have already studied in chapter number 12 of SST. Right. Now let's come to the second question. Okay. So in second question, children, what you have to do, you have to match the following in column A with the correct pictures in column B. Okay. So first one is national bird. Okay. All of you know which is our national bird. It is peacock. Okay. So the answer is peacock. Here I have written C. Okay. Now next is national flower. Okay. So national flower is lotus. Okay. It is a sacred flower and has a special place in the Indian culture. Okay. So the answer is lotus. You all can see in the box I have filled F. Now let's come to the third one. National emblem. Okay. So the national emblem, the answer is B. Okay. So our national emblem, if you see it clearly, it has got four lions, which is facing the four directions. But however, we can see only three lions at a time. And children, I told you that Ashoka Chakra have been taken from national emblem. You all can see here it is. Here Ashoka Chakra is there. And below Ashoka Chakra, what is written? Satyamev Jayate. Okay, Satyamev Jayate ka matlab kya hota hai? Truth alone trims. Matlab satya ki hi hamesha jeet hoti hai. Okay. So the answer is national emblem ka kya hai? B. Now let's move on to national animal. Okay. So our national animal is Royal Bengal Tiger. Okay. The answer is A. Royal Bengal Tiger. And this Royal Bengal Tiger, it stands for strength, bravery and power. Okay. Now children, let's move to the fifth one. Okay. So fifth one is E. The answer is E. That is mango. National fruit is mango. Okay. Now let's come to the sixth one. National sport. The answer is hockey. Okay, children. What is the answer? The answer is hockey. Okay. And children, one more thing you should know about this sport, that India has won 8 Olympic gold medals in hockey. How many? 8 Olympic gold medals. It is very important. Okay. Now, let's come to the 7th one. So, the answer of 6th is G. I hope till here it is clear to all of you. Now, the answer for 7th, national currency. The answer is rupee. Indian rupee. Okay. D1. So, a new symbol for the rupee has been recently. This new symbol has been recently designed by D. Uday Kumar. Okay. So you should remember this, that who have designed this symbol of rupee? D. Uday Kumar. Okay. Now children, so we are done with this chapter also, chapter number 32. I hope children, this chapter is very much clear to all of you. Okay. Now, Children, let's move to the another chapter, that is chapter number 35. I would like to tell you that chapter number 34 and 34 are not a part of your syllabus. Okay? So, we have directly come to which chapter? 35, Solar System. Now, this chapter also, bachcho, you have already studied in SST. And it is a very, very easy chapter. So, in our solar system, all the planets, they revolve around the sun, right? The sun sits in the middle, while the planets, they travel in circular path, okay? So, what happens, you see children, let me draw here, this is our sun, okay? And all the planets, they revolve around the sun in a circular planet, circular path, okay? And this circular path is called orbit. What is it called? It is called orbit. Okay? So, let's see what is written here. The sun sits in the middle while the planets travel in a circular path. That is called orbits. The eight planets travel in the same direction. Okay? Sun is a very big star. Okay? And sun and the stars produce their own light, whereas planets, they do not produce their own light. Okay, understood children? Sun and the stars, they produce their own light, whereas planets, they do not produce their own light. Now, few facts you should be knowing about the solar system. So, in our solar system, you see which planet is nearest to the sun? It is Mercury. So, the answer is Mercury is the nearest planet to the sun. And if you see children, which planet is farthest from the sun? It is Neptune. Okay, so Neptune is the farthest from the sun. Okay, now let's come to one more fact. Let's see which is the largest planet in the solar system. The answer is Jupiter. Okay, and the smallest planet is Mercury. Okay. So, children, you have to remember these four points. These are very important. First is Mercury is the nearest planet to the sun. Second is Neptune is the farthest planet from the sun. Third, Jupiter is the largest. And Mercury is the smallest. Okay. So, do you find it difficult to remember the right planets in this order? You don't have to worry. So, what you can do, you just have to remember this line. My very excellent mom just served us noodles. Okay? So, first letter of each word matches the first letter of each planet. Okay? So, you just have to learn this line and then you will be able to remember the right planets in the correct order. M stands for Mercury, V stands for Venus, E stands for Earth, M stands for Mars, J stands for Jupiter, S stands for Saturn, U stands for Uranus and N stands for Neptune. Okay? So, now it's easy for you to remember. Okay? Now, let's move on to the questions. Name the largest planet. The answer is Jupiter. Very easy. Name the planets nearest to the sun. The answer is Mercury. Name the planet farthest from the sun. The answer is Neptune. And the name the two planets which are neighbors of the planet Earth. So if you look here in the solar system, this is Earth. So the neighbors of Earth are Venus this side and Mars this side. So, the answer is Venus and Mars. Children, do you know that there was one more planet? Okay, before 2004, there was one more planet and the ninth planet name was Pluto. Okay, but now it has been removed from the list of planets. Children, do you know why it has been removed? Why? Because it is very small. Okay, that is why it has been removed from the list of planets. And now it is called dwarf planet. Dwarf matlab chota. Chota planet. Okay? तो अभी ये हमारे सोलर सिस्टम में जो एट प्लैनेट्स हैं उसमें ये काउंट नहीं किया जाता, ठीक है बच्चों। नाउ लेट्स कम टू दी नेक्स्ट चैप्टर, दैट इज 36th। ओके, सो द चैप्टर नेम इज ग्रीन अर्थ। ओके, सो दिस चैप्टर इज ऑल्सो वेरी इजी चिल्ड्रन। वॉट यू हैव टू डू इन द फर्स्ट इज टिक द करेक्ट ऑप्शन। ओके, सो द फर्स्ट इज व्हाट डज दिस सिंबल स्टैंड्स फॉर। ओके, सो दिस सिंबल चिल्ड्रन इट स्टैंड्स फॉर रिड्यूस, रिसाइकल एंड रीयूज। व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ रिड्यूस चिल्ड्रन? वी शुड रिड्यूस द अमाउंट ऑफ वेस्ट वी प्रोड्यूस, ठीक है। अब हम अपना जो वेस्ट हम प्रोड्यूस करते हैं उसको हम कैसे कम कर सकते हैं, सोचो जरा। अगर हम चीजों को कम खरीदे, जो हमारी जरूरत की चीजें हैं बस वही खरीदे, तो ऑटोमेटिकली जो वेस्ट है वो कम हो जाएगा, राइट। और बच्चों अगर हम चीजों को दोबारा से यूज करें तब भी हमारा जो वेस्ट है वो कम हो जाएगा। जैसे कि पानी, वॉटर वी कैन रीयूज अगेन एंड अगेन, राइट। सो दैट मीन्स वी आर रिड्यूसिंग द वेस्टेज ऑफ वॉटर। नाउ लेट्स मूव ऑन टू द सेकेंड, रिसाइकल। रिसाइकल मीन्स बच्चों वही चीज जो आपने यूज कर ली है उसको वापस से रिसाइकल करके यूज करना, रिसाइकल आइटम्स विच एवर इज पॉसिबल। फॉर एग्जाम्पल पेपर, पेपर कैन बी रिसाइकल्ड, राइट। प्लास्टिक, प्लास्टिक कैन बी रिसाइकल्ड एंड इट कैन बी यूज्ड अगेन, ठीक है। इससे क्या होगा बच्चों, इससे हमारे एनवायरनमेंट को कम डैमेज होगा, ठीक है। एंड थर्ड इज रीयूज। रीयूज मींस रीयूज आइटम्स एज मच एज यू कैन बिफोर रिप्लेसिंग देम। ओके, सो व्हाट यू शुड डू, यू शुड रीयूज एनीथिंग व्हिच एवर यू कैन reuse, fine. So this symbol it stands for reduce, recycle and reuse. Okay, now let's come to the second question, which of this animal is endangered. Okay, first of all what is the meaning of endangered? Endangered means anyone, any animal or any plant which is at a risk of extinction, मतलब जो इस दुनिया से खत्म होने वाले हैं, जिनकी पॉपुलेशन अब बहुत कम रह गई है और अगर हमने उन्हें प्रोटेक्ट करके नहीं रखा तो वो जल्द ही सारे सारे खत्म हो जाएंगे, ठीक है। तो दैट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ एंडेंजर्ड, विच इज एट द रिस्क ऑफ एक्सटेंशन। दैट मीन्स फ्यू ऑफ देम आर लेफ्ट एंड दे माइट soon wipe out altogether. Okay, so you know children that panda is an endangered animal, so it is our responsibility to protect panda. Okay, now let's come to the third one, which type of shopping bag is environment friendly? Children, you only think which type of shopping bag is environment friendly. The answer is cloth, क्योंकि हम क्लोथ के बैग को बार बार रीयूज कर सकते हैं, राइट। वी कैन वॉश इट एंड देन वी कैन रीयूज इट, राइट। बट यू कैन नॉट यूज द पेपर बैग अगेन एंड अगेन। एंड इफ यू आर यूजिंग द प्लास्टिक बैग, सी इट कॉजेज अ लॉट ऑफ पोल्यूशन, ओके, एंड इट डैमेजेस द एनवायरमेंट टू अ वेरी ग्रेट एक्सटेंट। ओके, सो बोथ ऑफ दीज आर रॉन्ग। ओके, वी शुड यूज क्लोथ for shopping, right? Cloth bag for shopping. Now let's come to the fourth one. When is Water Day celebrated? Children, Water Day is celebrated on 22nd March. And why do we celebrate water? क्यों Water Day हम क्यों celebrate करते हैं? ताकि हम लोगों को aware कर सके water की importance का और water के conservation का, मतलब हमें पानी कैसे बचा के रखना है ये हम लोगों को बता सके, इसीलिए हम वाटर डे सेलिब्रेट करते हैं, ठीक है बच्चों। आपको पता ही है कि हमारे अर्थ पे जो फ्रेश वाटर है वो सिर्फ 3% है, दैट इज ओनली 3%. सो इट इज आवर रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी टू कंजर्व एंड प्रोटेक्ट आवर वाटर रिसोर्सेज. ठीक है, सो वी शुड यूज द वाटर जुडिशियसली. ओके, नाउ चिल्ड्रन लेट्स कम टू द लास्ट क्वेश्चन ऑफ दिस क्लास. राइट, ट्रू और फॉल्स, स्विच ऑफ लाइट्स एंड फैंस व्हेन नॉट इन यूज. करेक्ट, सो द आंसर इज ट्रू. देन थ्रू अवे थिंग्स दैट कैन बी यूज्ड अगेन आफ्टर बीइंग रिपेयर्ड बाय अ न्यू वन. दिस इज रॉन्ग. ओके, यू शुड यूज द थिंग्स अगेन एंड अगेन. ओके, यू शुड नेवर गो फॉर अ न्यू वन इफ यू कैन यूज दैट थिंग अगेन. ओके, सो द आंसर इज फॉल्स. देन थर्ड इज कैरी योर फूड एंड ड्रिंक्स इन पॉली बैग्स. यू शुड नॉट कैरी इन पॉली बैग्स, यू शुड कैरी इट इन द क्लोथ बैग्स. सो द आंसर इज फॉल्स. ओके, कंजर्व वॉटर बाय यूजिंग अ बकेट एंड मग टू बेथ. ओके, द आंसर इज ट्रू. एंड फिफ्थ, राइट ऑन बोथ साइड्स ऑफ द पेपर. This is also true because it will help in conserving the paper. It will help the reduce of usage of paper. Okay, so the answer is true. I hope children, all the 5 chapters which we covered today, it is clear to all of you. Okay, now all of you please write the answers in your GK book. Okay, and children, all the best for your CT3 examination. If you have any doubt in any of the chapters which are coming in CT3, you can ask. Okay, you can just drop a message on my WhatsApp number. Okay, and then I will reply back to you. Okay, children, goodbye. Take care of yourself and happy Diwali to all of you.